So unwrapping. Unwrapping is the, I know it's a big issue for a lot of you. So let's discuss it, like, to make it a little bit easier and a little bit to understand it. Why do we unwrap? So let's go to basics. Why do I unwrap? So you can paste your textures on the model. But what is the point of unwrapping? So you got a model and you got a texture or whatever. So how should the software or whatever you're rendering at, you're rendering with, know which part of the texture should be appeared on which part of the polygon or which part of the model? This is the UV purpose and the sole purpose. So you have texture, you have, let's say, checker, and we need to make this square take this face. How you should do it? This is the unwrap. It tells which part of the model takes which part of the texture. So this is the basic. Now we understand this solo purpose of it. So how to achieve it and make it the most optimal, and how to make it perfect. So using themes, like, imagine you wrapping a gift for some friend or something. You got a mug or a cup. So you get paper gift and you gonna wrap it. How you gonna wrap it? This is precisely the inverse of it. You gonna unwrap the model on the texture. So you won't make less islands, less distorted, and you need to put seams. So what is seams? Seams is where you tell the software where to cut the model into pieces, like the seams on your clothes. Yeah. So this is the seams. In Blender, it's like this. You select an edge and Control E, mark seam. So Blender will understand that you will take this and separate it than the others. This is what Blender do. So how to think where to put my seams? So this is the model. I want this. Let's open our reference. So at here, this is pretty straightforward. It's like some sort of cube. So yeah, I got this face and the side and this other side and the top and the bottom. So this is pretty much it. So you want to put the seams where you want to make a whole piece of it. So I think this is, this front is the whole chunk. So yeah, Control E, Control L, clear seam. So yeah, this is the first side, so I will make it like unwrap. Yeah, see, perfect. And we will discuss textile density, which is not here. So let me install it. So what is textile density? Textile density is basically how to make your universe, your UV unwrapping is universe. So texture size, this model is like 30 centimeters in 15 centimeters or so. So yeah, how much texture do you need? So if it's, you gonna wrap a lot of parts separately, so how should it be? Like if we give it like a material, basic one. So see, you can make this and grab it. So you see here the difference between the scale of the squares, and they are the same texture. This is the same texture applied on those, but this takes a little bit resolution than this, and this is bad, which is gonna result, there's a little bit details gonna be vague and less quality than others in the same model, and this is not acceptable. So yeah, this model need to be the same exact scale of the square. So this is came the textile density. So you gonna calculate the textile density here, and you can do it by sight, but I'd like to be accurate. So I'm gonna take this, let's apply scale and calculate my textile density. It's 4.5 0.403. So let's make it unwrap. And there is some distortion, I don't know why. Preview view. Project from view. And okay. So that's it. Make it island. Okay. This is the first part and give it away. So let's put our scene. So this is gonna be our site. This is gonna be our top. And yeah, clear scene. Clear scene. And we're gonna put it here. And that's it. So let's see how we gonna separate it. And here. Now I know why it was distorted because these buttons, yeah. So we're gonna split this so it's nice. Array of squares. It's not gonna be visible enough, so we're gonna make it really small in the UV. Okay, so let's select Control L to select the chunk and say unwrap, and there is no distortion. Okay, cool. So hide this face, Control L, unwrap. So let's put here 0.403 and set to my pixel density. No. Yeah. Okay. Set. Okay, let's do first unwrap. And that's it. Whenever you do your seams right, everything's fit perfectly. Yeah, like this. So these buttons need to be adjusted. Oh, not bad. Okay, let's see what is going on wrong here. So where is it? Yeah, this is it. Yeah, I forgot. I need to do like this and like this. Anything is distorted here? No, nice, 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 clean and steady. Okay, so we got one last thing, that is this one, right? So this is fairly easy, slender, nah, clear scene. Okay, and we will put here. And I want to do it. Okay. Okay. Good. So whenever I do unwrap, yeah. So here is the thing. Just do it like this. So here is the thing, I want these like straightforward, like a straight line and connected. So how to do this? Well, there is this and it's okay, it's messed up, so we gonna need it manually. So first of all, I'm gonna select these and align it. Let me align this. So, me testing this like control B packet, so if my PC can do it any better, no. This is the optimal solution. Unless, yeah, of course we forgot these. Unwrap. That's easily done. Here. We got plenty of rooms here. So for this one, I will split. And to save some space, I'm gonna instant this. Yeah. And we'll do it like this. Mirror X. And shift it like UDIMS. So this tile is size to 256 pixels. So if I press GX256, yep. So what does this make? It makes that this, let me show you. So if I make it GX256, this overlaps the other one, right? So what will happen when I bake? If I leave it like this, it will make some artifacts and some problems, cause it's gonna bake the same position or the same area of the UV twice. So it's gonna make some problems. So when I do this, like items, it just ignores the baking and this just copy it. So clean baking and give it a good smooth, and don't worry if it's broken like this, and we are good to go for texturing. So let me see you there. So couple of things to have to do before jumping to texturing substance painter. First of all, I need to scale these to the proportional scale, centimeter, make it meters, and okay, well, okay, this is big. Yeah, 40 scale like that. Sorry, scale. And these flip normals, these issues. Okay, this is it. So let's do some things. First of all, gather all the buttons here and split them. Yep. And for these, them actually don't need you. Okay, and this, nope. And for this one, yeah, split them. So why I do such thing to make this? Vertex paint, shift K, vertex paint, shift K, vertex paint, shift K, except for these. Make it like this. Yeah. Now we will do it in substance. So shift K. Then with the vertex, yeah. Okay, we are good. So whenever I do this, I'm making vertex paint. That widened. Yeah. Cool ID. This is gonna help me mask things in Substance Painter. Okay. So I need to make this. Meshes and scan and scroll low, yeah. And this is gonna be the high one. File, export, FBX, select the object. Yeah, it's in the origin. No, it's not the origin. So cursor selected, they should have the same origin. Yep, they are in the origin now. Rotation, scale, file export, fix. Yeah, this. Yep, and we are done in Blender.